And you've got to wonder what that means for Fnatic sort of throughout the rest of the tournament here. But I definitely think Fnatic will win. We are about to go live here, so hope you guys are ready for it. Fnatic, they get to start on the terrorist side, and Vexed going to be on the CT side. And I have to agree with Thorin once again. I think Fnatic could easily win both sides on this map.
That's going to be the main issue here for Vexed. It's just that they have to come out swinging. I mean, it's always the case with the underdogs where they just need to get so many rounds where it's just they're not going to give Fnatic any room to work with in the next half, right? They have to be able to come out really strong here. And Vexed, especially in this current meta for CT, where it just feels so important to pick up the first three rounds to get your nades and everything.
I think this is Vexed having looked at Fnatic demos. Otherwise, I don't think you'd put a setup where you only have two people in B, and really only one. Grubby's in drop down. This is an insane setup here for Vexed. And because Fnatic are actually hitting the B bomb site, that's a lot of trouble here. Grubby going to go down the leaves. Only one of the backlines Furlan alive for just one kill, and he's going to be gone to Crims. JW fighting. He takes one. Still got one bullet left, but he's not going to get a chance to reload. Pete will take him out. Bomb is down, though, and it's a 2v3.
Yeah, and Crims gets the necessary info. They already knew one player was playing from Connector. Now they know where the rest of them are coming from as well. The two players here for Vexed trying to push onto this site. They have to worry about the Triangle of Doom that has been set up, and look at that. It just looks so easy. Everybody peeks at the same time. Olafmeister and Flush are both finding headshots in the end, and this is the worst-case scenario for Vexed. Just starting off, getting hammered in the pistol, especially when it's so important for you to get the confidence to go up against a top-tier team like Fnatic, to just get slammed right from the start. Fnatic, you know, not that they had a shred of mercy before, you know, in the Manders, you know, they're already demonstrating that now.
Not really, not really. I mean, traditionally, and you guys will see this throughout the tournament as well, the meta game right now on this map, if you're on the CT side, you end up stacking as many people as you think you possibly can get away with on the B bomb side. And especially in pistol rounds, you kind of got to control drop and mid. Pronax here, and a bit of an adventure. He goes down, and so does Crims. Falls to Rallen. Bit of a return frag there with the sawn-off shotgun on Pete from JW, but still, this is a bit of a questionable second round from Fnatic. Yeah, I definitely think Vexed had something planned for that pistol round that was outside of the norm, because otherwise I don't think they would have gone for that setup.
This is where Fnatic have to be careful, though. Like that pistol, it went really well for them. Now they can't get too excited. Perfect play there, using the Molotov to check the angle. Now we're into the 3-on-3 take here on the B site. Fnatic getting set up now to get that bomb plant down, but Rollin with the dig, he's already taking out JW.
Nice shot there, Furlan. Going to be taking down Olafmeister. Flusher alone, and you did say it, the most consistent player in tournament history here, and we'll see if he can actually clutch this 1v3. He's got the time for it, and he's got certainly the weapon as well. He's going to be walking around here about 30 seconds left now. You've got to be really careful. The bomb is out in the open as well, and the Polish players there on the other side. Flusher going to take down Rallen. Now Grubby, the only one left alive, and see if he can actually find him here.
This is a really clever gamble. Fnatic, I mean, you can clearly tell that Flusha expects there to be a backstab of some sort, that it was a crossfire, but Vex put both players onto that site. So Flusha, he's having to figure this out. He's actually going to walk right into Grubby, and Grubby with the CZ75, this close, just takes the shot.
He's got no bullets. He's out of ammo now. He's only got the knife. He's around the corner. Flusha going to take him out. It's ridiculous. Oh, no. I was wondering, why did you stop shooting? I hadn't noticed, and that was going to be it. He only had the one bullet. It had to be a headshot, and it wasn't. What a way to start. It's going to put us into the third round here, and Vexed, I mean, even if they did so much damage, for them to buy now and try and put Fnatic economically behind, that would be insane.
No, there's no way. They took their risk. You can see, I mean, a couple of players have actually got some money going into this. That's why you see Rollin going up to a Deagle, for example. A bit more of an expensive pistol to work with here rather than going for the cheap P250 option. But yeah, three guys on Vexed having to go for the hard eco. And this will give, I mean, JW another chance to put that sawn off. Pretty much the only guy who does this, he's the man who started doing this, using this sawn off shotgun. It's the shortest range shotgun. But when you're up close like this, he's just looking for an easy target and drop. Not going to find one, though. And there, you see him swap out to the CZ once he has to do the long-range work.
And that's all there is to it. Also, I think a bit of a sign that, you know, they want to keep their confidence a bit here on the Fnatic side. Not afraid of that last round. JW will go down. Not the biggest loss, but when Crims dies as well, that's a very bad start. Pronax trying to bring it back, and Grubby's going to go down to a grenade there. And a good follow-up from Flusher with a double kill. It's going to be Rallen and Pete left, and Fnatic stabilizing here, but I think some rounds here that are more expensive than Fnatic were really looking for, so I'd say so far Vexed have done a pretty good job.
In these second rounds, you're right. I mean, the follow-up, where it was a 1v1, and now it's going to be a 1v3, unless Pete can actually manage to pull off something here. He is playing from drop, but Flush is watching the angle. If Pete tries to come around this corner, Flush will spot him. Very nice work there, and no escape. An extra 300 bucks go into Flush's pocket, and another round on Fnatic's score. So 3-0, and now we go into the first big buy round. This is going to be the second crucial moment, essentially, after that pistol for Vexed. Now they've got the rifles, now they've got the nades. They have to figure out where Fnatic are going to take this fight.
Yeah, no EWP picked up on anybody yet, so a bit of an interesting sign. In spite of the, you know, if you look at the map architecture, it looks like a map that lends itself very well to AWPing. It's not always necessary. It's been proven time and again that you can control pretty much every choke on this map without an EWP, so some teams make really good use of it. We've seen Mouse Sports, I think, a couple of games where Chris J has gone completely mad with it, but it's not, I think, a requirement in that sense.
I mean, the one round that comes to mind is when he got an ace right up here in the apartments, and
yeah,
that was ridiculous. But, you know, sometimes Chris J, he's just one of those players who can go completely wild. We will have the defensive smoke go up into drop, so only a single man holding there for now. That's Groovy. The rest of the DB defense, Hyper and Furlough, and they're hanging out on the site itself, and one is close to drop. So it's going to come down to whether Olafmeister, the man who used to just be dominant on Plateau until people started to figure out his tendencies, he's going to be taking point here.
50-some seconds left. They are going to make their way out on that plateau. Hyper playing close up. Furlan's a little bit further back behind the statue, and they've got to be careful. Nice shot there. Hyper going to take down one. Still got plenty of bullets left here. He's playing with the M4A4. They've done terrific damage already. Fnatic very low, and if they get this round Vex, then Fnatic won't have that much money. And a double grenade to take down both those players. Crimson JW gone in one split second, and it's going to be up to Flusher now. 1v5. Trying to see if he can stay alive up here and maybe do a little bit of damage. They need at least a couple of kills, and Flusher is going to give him the first one.
Yeah, he's still got that bomb. He's just not going to have the time. He's got 20 seconds left, 34 HP. Finds two kills so far, but he's in a 1v3, and the flank is going to come in from Pete. Easy kill there. But what that round boils down to is the nades. When we're talking about Vex going into this rifle, why they're needing to save all their money in the third round when they lost the force buy in the second, they needed all the nades that they possibly could have, and this is why. Fnatic, they get bogged down. It was actually one big anti-flash that got thrown in by Vex.
Wow.
The timing was perfect. It stopped all three players on Fnatic on that plateau, and that allows for Vex to get into position to just whittle Fnatic down. So Fnatic, they need to be more decisive. When they're throwing out those flashes, they have to take advantage of it, because then they just turn into targets. Then there's nothing they can do.
Can I just, because this is the first time that we actually get a chance to do this, Semla, can we just give a bit of an appreciation for how incredibly skilled the PGL team is at doing their stuff? It's so cool. Like all the camera angles and all the replays there. I love it. Mm-hmm. Now, fifth round is coming up, and that early round win here for Vexed, because they did the damage earlier on, Fnatic, they're back to almost nothing here.
Yeah.
This used to be a strength of Fnatic, just like with Envy. They keep buying, they keep putting the pressure on, and eventually the opponent breaks. But right now it's Vex putting on the pressure, and we'll see if they can pick up this win as well. It'll be a huge turnaround early on.
Oh, I like the change of pace here from Pronax. They're going to change up all the angles. Good spray going on to Pronax, though. That's an AK down, but it immediately gets picked up by Crims, and JW in drop finds a kill on Groovy with that shotgun. But it's going to be Pete. He's boosted up. They have no idea, Fnatic. They walk right into him, and that's completely falling apart now for Fnatic. Once again, it's going to be one last man standing here, Olafmeister. He's got that bomb, but he has no way to get out onto the site.
Fantastic round so far from the Polish side, and see if Olaf can do a bit of damage. He's going to walk right into Rowling. Goes down. They lost two people last round on Vex's side. This time it's only one, so their economy is going to be stronger. Fnatic, no bomb plant. They just won't have the money to buy. This is a really big switch early in the game.
And I'm sure we're going to get this replay, and here it is. It's so unfortunate for Fnatic, just in the sense that Pete's in the one spot that will counter that smoke execute. You saw how the smokes were blooming. Fnatic had just nicely cut off connector. They cut off behind Van as well. They would only have to worry about the site itself. But then Pete just happens to be boosted up. He spots them making his way out. And of course, yeah, Vex are just going to keep putting them up there. Like, okay, now Fnatic, you got a real threat here. How are you going to handle it?
Oh. So far, they're playing it very cool on the CT side. You can tell already that they've got a lot of grenades saved, even in that B bomb site where you tend, especially if you're a little bit nervous, which you would be playing Fnatic at this point, you tend to throw all your grenades on that plateau right at the beginning because you don't want to be rushed down. But they're doing a really good job. They're keeping that cool here. You got Grubby picking up three kills, no hesitation at all, and it's going to be a smooth round here from Vex Gaming. This is turning into a very, very interesting game already.
Yeah, this is ugly. Fnatic want to running in one after another. You know, these aren't the, you know, this is one of the teams that basically started off with the death group, with the group that would run around. It would be like three or four players, and they just march right through as a group. So if one of them goes down, doesn't matter, because the next one in line is going to be able to pick up that refrag, and that's how Fnatic would just, you know, pound their way through the defense. we're just watching Fnatic get picked off one at a time. I mean, granted, it is an anti-eco around here for Vexed. Nothing really picked up for Fnatic, only pistols. But now we need to see if that's going to carry through, if Fnatic are going to keep hesitating and losing players one at a time.
Right, but so many matches where Fnatic are a little bit down, then they at least get so much out of their eco rounds that you know, they still get the damage in, so the other team has to buy up a lot of rifles here. Only one who's lacking money right now is Hyper on the CT side and on Fnatic. We'll see again, no AWP, still not a single one being in play so far, and we're starting off in the seventh round here. See if they can change their pace very quick in the middle. Just the terrorist side, just establishing a bit of control. You can see the bomb is not picked up yet, so they haven't gone for any kind of real push, although all of Meister trying to get out on that plateau is going to get shut down by Hyper.
Yeah, that was great read there by Hyper. Again, Pete boosted up, is going to pick off Pronax. JW will be there to take out Groovy, but this is the threat now, is that JW controls this connector area. Timing couldn't be worse for him to pull out a nade, though JW goes down and Rollin takes out Flusha in the meantime. So it's going to be down to Krim's last man here in a 1v4 for Fnatic. But again, just getting picked off one after another. These are the sorts of situations where there's just so much individual talent on Fnatic. They could excel in, you know, they're going to win those duels. But we saw, what, 2-3 kills there where Fnatic, there's just no way for them to answer.
And look at this right here. Also, the setup from Vex's side. You can tell how keenly aware they are that they need to stay alive with all these rifles. They can't give anything up. And they also realize that if they fight Krims one at a time, there's a real chance he'll win all of those four fights and clutch the round. So they're not giving him really much to work with here. He's going to spot one guy in the corner, and you see him clicking it away. It's Furlane going down, and Hyper hiding in the background here by the henhouse. Krims has the bomb, and he really wants to put it down. Going to just test it once. Hyper should be in an optimal position, and now they're closing in around him, so time is essentially up for Krims. He's just going to go for the plant, and once he gets it down, he shouldn't be able to escape. He goes down to Hyper. It's about the best that Krims could have already done there. So a kill and a bomb plant, it's going to give them a little bit more to work with, but still, I've got to say, right now, I'm really impressed by Vex here so far.
They're looking excellent. They're looking very good. Dialed in on what Fnatic are trying to throw at them here. They're winning all the individual duels with clever positioning. The timing that it worked out as well. Olafmeister, those two steps that he took before he dropped that flash, that's all Hyper needed to turn away from the flash, not be blinded, and take Olafmeister out before he could get through the smoke. Those kinds of situations, I mean, Vex are clearly showing that they're up to snuff, that they're up to the task. And now we have to see, you know, Fnatic, because of that bomb plant, because Krims went for the safe play rather than trying to win the round, he just guaranteed his team the money. Now they actually get a buy out of it. But again, Vexed, changing it up. This time we're seeing a boost and drop.
I'm super curious about what grenade it is Vexed is throwing over at A long, because they keep putting the same grenade up over there, and we haven't really seen it yet. So maybe we can follow that in one of the upcoming rounds. Right now, Hyper playing close to the hole in the wall here by the plateau. See if he could find someone early on, but looks like they might try and boost him up here. Get a bit of an edge on the Fnatic team.
Oh, they want to put the AWP up there, Furlane now. That's a little bit dangerous. A good flash and rushing bodies coming out of there. I mean, an AWP can kind of work against you sometimes. If you get that one shot and you miss it, you could just get overrun. Oh, I thought he was going to pull the trigger there for a second. That would have been scary.
He's ready for it, and he's got Hyper here, maybe to try and slow them down a little bit. Nobody so far from Vex is pushing up anywhere, so they're going to be careful. Olafmeister's going down here. Grubby's going to spray down one. He goes for a second. Can't land it. Still a really good start here for Vex as they get a couple of kills in. See if they can actually get the bomb down on this site. Fnatic, though, in the corner. Hyper's hiding. He's going to only get the one kill, so still not a bad situation either for Fnatic. They could just get the bomb plant through, but Pronax stopping in the middle of everything. A little bit of hesitation, and that gets him killed.
Now it's JW. He spots him as well, but they see him go up to the platform. Now he's kind of stuck. Oh, he wants to go for the AWP. Could go for the shots. He's going to miss the first one. Just dancing around. This is pure JW here, but the smoke goes down to block him off. And now this gives Vexed a little bit of room to move. Again, JW, is he just going to be trying to go for the plant? He's only got 7 seconds left. He doesn't have time to mess around. He hits the first shot. 4 seconds, just enough time to get this bomb plant. And now he's turned it into a 1v1. JW, he's in a position to win this, but he has to figure out where the second man is. He has to figure out where Pete's playing from. And if Pete actually walks around this corner, he could actually pick off JW, but JW is on the hunt. He's closing in. Pete checks and Pete hits the headshot. A clutch win this time for Vexed in a 1v1 versus one of the best clutchers in the world.
Yeah, and I mean, for anyone new watching, that kind of movement, I hope you guys can tell at home how different it is when JW does it from almost every other player. You have that sense that he probably could have pulled that off, but really good job from Vexed and not giving up that initial bomb site there, buying enough time for the rotation to come in. Hyper hiding in the corner. Not a lot that you can do there. He got the kill and died, but it all bought time for the players in the A bomb site to try and get there. Now 5-3, and that's 5 straight rounds in a row here for Vexed. And the early kill on Furlane here onto Krims. It'd be a really good start.
That's a shame we didn't see it from his perspective, because Fnatic were putting flashes in there for just that kind of situation. So it might have been that he was blinded, but he had the angle, pulled the trigger, and Crims just happened to be standing there. But another thing going wrong here for Fnatic at the beginning of a very crucial round. Hyper's right on the edge, but this time Ulfmeister, he's through the smoke and ready and waiting, so he brings it back to a 4-on-4. And now this is a situation that favors Fnatic.
It absolutely is, and they've got plenty of time as well. I am curious about the fact that Vex don't go for any kind of information play over on that A side, because you know, they have, I mean, obviously we can look at the minimap and see they have the room for it, but teams usually try at some point, so we'll see if that's going to happen. Grubby here, spray, but not going to get the kill, and that's going to leave a lot of trouble for Rallen.
And Olaf already in position here, trying to look onto that site. Rallen gets caught out by Pronax. It's going to be Pete and Furlan, the remaining two players here for Vex, both playing from connector. Fairly standard fare. Fnatic, though, they should have time to set up that triangle defense. And there's the first kill. JW just peeks out, takes Furlan's face off. And it's going to be down to Pete now. Last man remaining here for Vexed. So Fnatic starting to get some momentum. JW, a free AWP, playing from the back as well. And will he get the shot? Yes, he will. JW, fine work from him. Two kills in the end. But there's an important round for Fnatic, keeping three players alive as well, so they can actually drop two AKs and get a very good, good buy in this round.
Okay, so what we could almost say this round is that Vexed fell fell victim to what we could call the cobblestone challenge, which is when you have only a player in drop and one in B, or even if you have two in B, what tends to happen is as soon as you lose control of either plateau or drop, you get sandwiched in on the side. You have to hold both, which is why some teams have tried to figure out like different ways of holding so that it doesn't just all depend on that one guy getting killed. Because as soon as Grubby went down and dropped, there was almost no way that Rallen was going to hold on to that site. It's very, very hard to do.
You're just exposed. One flank gets completely opened up. What it looked like to me watching the minimap there, where those A players were playing from for Vexed, it looked like they were actually trying to set up to counter that smoke play that we saw from Fnatic earlier. They were really close up to the apartments, the entrance there, so they would be within that smoke radius. So already you can see the teams kind of just adjusting their play here based on what they've seen.
Oh, Pete turning his back. If that flashbang actually saved him, and he's back around the corner, he's got to be very, very careful right now. And he's going to be down by JW ultimately. So now that's 5 versus 4. Rallen hiding in the corner. Pop flash comes out, and JW's going to walk right in front of him. Rallen actually, some trigger discipline. He's going to get the kill. Could have maybe got a second one on Olaf. A little bit preoccupied behind him. It's going to be Flusher to take him out. And now it's looking good still. 3 versus 3 here in favor of Fnatic, who are on the bomb side. They just need the bomb to get up here.
Good pacing here by Vex. They're waiting for that bomb plant sound. There's the shot, the peek from connector. Find the perfect timing to take out Ulfmeister, and now it is that man advantage. See if Furlan can make it last, though. Pronax is going to take him out, and it's going to be down to Grubby and Hyper, the remaining two players here for Vex. Trying to move up, but this time Pronax stepping up his game, turns it into a 1v1. Krims has got the advantage due to health, but then Hyper with the angle steps out, catches Krims looking the wrong way. And Vexed will be picking up that 6th round.
And an absolutely crucial round win here. Again, shutting down the Fnatic economy. They get the bomb plant because they killed 4 people. This would be where I could see Fnatic taking a big risk here and just saying, all right, we have to buy. We know that we killed 4 of them. We know that their economy is going to be impacted by it, and ours is going to be just good enough here. So they will risk it and try and buy. It's not really a big risk considering that they can still buy 3 AKs and Illil and Stornoff here. I'm not too bothered about that. Not sure if I think the Stornoff is worth it at this point. I think I would have much rather have seen JW with a Tech-9. Tech-9 armor
just
and grenades.
JW things, right?
Yeah, but it's especially ridiculous because they actually don't have that many grenades on everyone else. He could have had a lot more to work with.
He's going to be taking point, actually. He gets spotted, though. Great spray by Grubby, but this is... What a mid-air headshot onto Krims! Okay. I thought for a second there that JW had done his job. If Krims' feet had touched the ground, he could have taken that fight. What a crucial kill.
Yeah.
And well, there goes the shotgun. You know, the whole point of that shotgun is to go and die, but get the info for his team to follow up and get the kill. And now it's falling apart now for Fnatic. Grubby finds a headshot on Ulfmeister.
He's gone mad at this point. Furlan going to take a kill on Pronax, and Flush is the last man left. He's looking like a clean victory here in the 11th round for Vexed. And I've got to say, I'm very impressed. And, you know, not to be that guy, but what would have happened if there had been a Tech-9 in front there and a pop flash in to try and stop Grubby from getting that kill? You know, saying those grenades actually do matter, especially when you take drop like this. But this second kill from Grubby is ridiculous.
Yeah, it's just the timing. Again, it's disjointed on Fnatic's side. Krims was just a couple seconds too late, and that gives Grubby the time to reset and you know, we're talking about, you know, Fnatic players just dying one after another. That's a clear case of it. Krim's trying to force it afterwards. He's trying to like, okay, well, now I know there's a guy there. Maybe I can get it, but he's just that half second too late. But this is a level of like hesitation that we're not used to seeing from Fnatic. We're used to seeing them win these duels straight up, and then if it comes down to the brute force method, just being very good on, you know, the timing between when teammates take fights and being able to follow up to get the refrag, which is basically get the follow up kill.
Well, this is going to be a bit of a cleanup here. Krims with a kill just to try and do a little bit, and Kronax is going to be overrun at the end. I've actually heard it said from various top teams, when they have some of these sort of, you know, kind of bad performances, especially early on, you ask them afterwards, what happened? Well, they say, well, we came into this match with a plan, but somehow we forgot about it until very late in the game, and suddenly we realized, wait a minute, why don't we just do what we plan to do? And then they pick it up again, which sounds a little bit ridiculous, and especially at a major level, you should be there. They've got a coach there as well. Everything should be on point. But right now, it definitely feels like Fnatic are, you know, they're not sticking to what we usually see them do, and it is a little bit upsetting.
Lacking that confidence.
Pete with some early damage here in the follow-up Molotov. Are they going to really try to go for this? They will. He actually burns himself, and that's not the best way to start.
That's a little awkward. Explaining that to the teammates. We have the rotation now coming out towards that A side as well. That's going to be Furlan trying to get over there, put that AWP into play. He's looking into mid as well, so if JW takes that peek, he sometimes does. He steps out there, that could be an opportunity for Vex to bring this back. But Fnatic, they still have the nades necessary for an execute if they want to go for it. They're a little light on the flashes, but they all still have their smokes. So they could make this really tricky here for Vexed, who are playing far back on the site this time. There's no boosted up Pete. There's nobody holding close to the entrance to the apartment. So this could be the moment here for Fnatic to really go for that A smoke.
See if they're going to try and do it. I would say as soon as you get that opening frag, rotating B must be very, very tempting for Fnatic because it's so hard to hold B with once you're a man down. But they're going to try and see if they could do it here. Furlan with a good opening frag on all of Mice. That's going to even out the odds a little bit here, but Molotov goes up to buy some time. 30 seconds for Fnatic to make it in. Are they going to have the time?
He's cutting it really close. Rollin and Furlan. There's the crossfire. It's going to be down to Flush and Krims, and Groovy right below the balcony manages to pick off the one. Still, Krims alive. We've seen him get close before, but it's not meant to be this time around. And what's going on? Like, Fnatic throwing two smokes into connector as well? Is the communication not on point right now? Are they doubting each other?
Yeah, there's definitely something up. And again, I think you mentioned the word hesitation. You can tell, you know, how once they telegraph that they're on the site, like, there's no point in really stopping too much at that. You've got to keep moving. And they were really slowing down. Good position from Grubby as well, because he can see the shadow on the floor before, on the ground before anything actually happens. So he's really able to get those pre-fires in there.
And, you know, you've got the guys set up in apartments. If Olafmeister, why isn't there a flash coming out of the apps? You know, just something towards that connector area. I mean, obviously, 20-20 hindsight, etc. But, you know, the likelihood of Furlan, he's shown that he likes to play connector with that AWP. So if you're just going to step out into the open right in front of him, that is a little bit risky. 14th round, though, and now Fnatic, it's a combination buy. It's a quasi-buy coming out from them. A few Tech-9s, some P250s, handful of nades, and it's going to be the push onto the B site very quickly here, but Hyper and Groovy are in position. Furlan still alive on this site. Right there on the edge, Kronax is gone, and another four players living for Vex. They just seem to be getting these rounds, racking up these rounds, where it's just very clean wins versus Fnatic. $12,000 on Groovy.
Yeah, so for this 15th round, they've got everything that they could possibly need. No need for any extra money here. And we are in the last round of the first half, so we'll see how much further they can push it here. I mean, even if this finishes 11-4, I won't rule Fnatic out of it. Historically, they've shown to be a team that can make some pretty ridiculous comebacks, and the skill gap between these two teams should be such that Fnatic can sort of rectify almost anything. But right now, I've got to say this Polish team is looking great. Good opening from Flusher, and Pete, less trigger discipline this time, and he ends up dying for it.
Yeah, they didn't even check that corner going right in. But some good anti-flashes again coming out here from Vex, trying to slow Fnatic down. Pronax up on the side is going to spot the first man close, and he does manage to survive as well, playing peekaboo. Not going to work in the end. Two on two now, and out in the open, Furlan just gets completely slapped. Hyper is now going to be in a 1v2 versus Flusha and Krims. Still some nades left to use as well. Krims could chuck that flash to buy some more time. He's just going to dunk an HE in there, though, but doesn't really do any damage. And there's no saving in the last round of the half, Anders.
No, it's going to be all up to Hyper here, see if he could clutch it. He's got a little bit of time with the kit as well, picked up a smoke there, he only had the Molotov before. See if he could put that to good use, but he's already making a bit of noise. They know where he is, and Fnatic, they're playing very well together right now, just trying to see if they can distract him, and that's going to be it. Flusher with the last kill there, triple for him in the round, and a 10-5 scoreline. Top fragger is Flusher in spite of them being pretty far behind together with Furlan there, but overall, you know, Olofmeister kind of almost disappearing from the match here. 3 kills in 15 rounds. It's not good enough.
It's the return of the old guard. The first major winning team, you know, Flush and JW Pronax, they were part of the original Fnatic roster that won the first major for CSGO ever. And Crimson Olofmeister, we're not used to seeing these guys sit at the bottom. I mean, Crims on CT side is really his time to shine a lot of the times, it seems. But Olaf, you know, he's the kind of guy who just steps in and gets work done. So for him to be sitting on 3 frags, feels almost odd. Doesn't feel like you should be able to say it, but like, is there so much pressure on Fnatic right now that, you know, they have so much on their minds? Is this impacting their game at all?
It could well be. I mean, that it must be that there is a lot of pressure on them. You can tell. I think Olaf though is the kind of person who responds well to it, but it might not be. I mean, I'm actually wondering now. We've got like a minute and a half here between the two halves. I'm not sure if that's going to be quite enough time for Olaf to get really angry at himself. But I think if they come close, or if they lose this match, but even if they come close to losing it, actually probably even after this performance in the first half, Olaf is going to go backstage and have a serious conversation with himself and say, hey, this is not good enough, and he's going to come back stronger. But it kind of needs to be now, though.
Exactly. They're running out of rounds to basically mess around with here. 10-5.
Yeah.
And that is not a very good scoreline for Fnatic, especially considering, you know, Cobblestone has kind of taken that shift over towards more of a T-sided map. Right now, they just got rolled. That's it, the long and short of it. They just got completely rolled over by a team that they probably went into this thinking, this shouldn't be a problem. Vex, you know, that is actually a weakness that's been shown by some top teams in the past. You know, VP were one of them. Fnatic has been burned by this in the past as well, where it's like they underestimate their opponents sometimes. They just think, you know, what's the next match? Oh, right, okay, so we might be playing either Luminosity or Cloud9. What are we going to do there? And that can cost you. You can never allow yourself to let your guard down versus these teams.
Yeah, I feel like maybe, I mean, I feel like certainly I understood Vexed a little bit. I expected maybe they could get into double figures, but, you know, that was at the end of the second half, not at the beginning of it. So we're going to see here, second half is coming up right now. The Polish team Vexed leading with 5 rounds against Fnatic. Now they're going to be playing the terrorist side, see if they can win the pistol round. They didn't win the pistol in the first half, though, and if they had, just imagine what the scoreline would have been.
Yeah, incredible. They would have completely tombstoned Fnatic. But now, well, it seems to me like Furlan is kind of dancing around on the edge of platform, trying to look for an opening in the smoke. Olofmeister going to drop one down, and now it's going to turn into this waiting game, the mind games between these plateau players. Who's going to peek where? Bomb is still kind of hanging around B side as well. But Vexed, I do like the fact that they are checking behind them to make sure that nobody on Fnatic side is pushed in over at A. Shots. Some random shots going through there onto Olofmeister.
Which is so cheap to do with a Glock as well, because you have so many bullets, you might as well try it. Still putting out a little bit while the rest is rotating back towards the A bomb sign. Flusher, I think he may have spotted them out. Olaf gonna win that first fight though. We'll see if they can make it all the way back. Flusher, the only one holding the A bomb sign, trying to see if he can look for a couple of kills here as they cross by. It would be important, but Rallen's gonna take him out. Pronax with a shot through, drops him in return, and Grubby trying to control the hole there, but not gonna make it work. JW, the dual elite's gonna get 2 kills, all headshots, looking for another one here. He's clicking calmly away. Look at the dancing going on there. Crims finally gonna be able to take down Pete, and no bomb plant, and Fnatic winning a really important round for themselves.
That was some Hollywood stuff. If JW had been flying through the air, both guns blazing, I would have believed it, right? Because he's just dancing. He's got so many bullets, he doesn't have to worry about reloading. So he's just like, I'm actually just going to try and stay alive as best I can. Maybe one of these bullets that I'm, you know, filling the air with will connect with them. But the important thing is just make myself a hard target to hit.
Max Payne style?
Damn straight. Bullet time. But, I mean, now Fnatic. Wow, look at this from Fnatic, though. They go full SMG, apart from one shotgun on Olofmeister. They have to realize that Vex could go for the force buy. And yeah, we see the trade kill in underpass already, and it looks like Vex just wants to go straight out onto the site, but what a long-range shot from Olofmeister. Headshot onto Furlan to get the first kill.
He's down to 4 health, so got to be a little bit careful. Crim's holding a really good angle here, minimal exposure for him. They are dropping very low on the Polish side as well. Pronax picking up 2 with the SMG, and Hyper going to be the last guy left, making a lot of noise, and Crim's doesn't wait to shoot until his feet hit the ground. He's just going to go midair instead. So a good round here for Fnatic overall. Even though they lost a couple of players, because they had all those SMGs in the shotgun, it's still gonna kind of pay off for them.
Yeah, now we can start to see that kind of upgrade going in here. Slowly but surely, they'll eliminate the SMGs. They have the money. So they're just going to go straight up to the M4 rifles here. Pronax and JW, we can see going for those. Good nade count here on Fnatic as well. And this is just going to be the hard eco out of Vex. No surprise. No bomb plant either round. no bomb plant, and so they are really light on money at this point. So Furlan might actually have a little bit of an issue getting enough money for that AWP, unless they can get a bomb plant here in this round, Vexed. It'll be a little tricky for them to really establish that strong offense.
Flusher almost getting caught then. It was a little bit scary because if he's a little bit further up, then they double peek him and he's only got the SMG. That could be ugly. And we'll see how much Vexed are going to rely on that AWP. I mean, Fnatic were in a position in that first half where they almost couldn't afford it. Maybe like once or twice they could have, but they didn't really choose to go for it.
Shots. Well, there we go. Flusher. At least he catches out Furlan here, and it seems like JW's got an idea. Spots one man. They trade places, so he doesn't actually know how many people are coming at him, but they are trying to keep the pressure up here, just whittling him down, and eventually JW will fall without getting a single kill, but a touchdown nade does massive damage from Pronax. And it's going to be that 3-on-4. Now a 2-on-4 as Crims rotates in to support his teammate, and it is going to be down to Groovy and Hyper. They have the M4, and they're hoping to make good use of it. I mean, Hyper still crouched back there on Plateau. Perhaps he's going to be able to pick up a surprise kill, but Olfmeister spots him. And with that Swag 7, it's going to be really tough for him to stay alive.
Oh, you got Crims killed at least, so still not too bad of a round here for Vex. Getting a couple of kills in with minimal investment. And here we see they are going to go for all AKs. AWP will be picked up on the other team, though, and JW obviously the guy to wield that. So 10-8, and suddenly it seems like a very open game again here. Fnatic winning two pistol rounds, it does have a really big impact on the game still.
Yeah, and Furlan was at 4,700. He was just $50 short of affording that AWP. I was curious to see if he would just barely make it, and then be able to go for a glass cannon, something to play with there. But instead, Vex prioritizing the HEs. JW up close to it. He did not spot the AK barrel there?
No, I don't think he did. Now he's sitting right at the edge. A bit interesting.
Oh, this could be really scary. Once these nades start coming in here, JW, yeah, he needs some room to work with. He needs to be able to give himself an out to just stay alive a little bit longer. Molotovs, flashes, full smokes, and the Molotov behind the box as well. JW, if he's right on the edge, he needs to hit that first shot, but he's got nowhere to go.
They line up for Crims, and he gets two in return. Grubby with a double of his own, though, and now it's back into a 2v3. Grubby, see if he can pull his team through right now. 50 seconds left. A grenade is going to be raining in. Bombs still not planted. The Fnatic have so much time, but Grubby finding a third kill, and Pronax crouched in the corner. He's going to win that fight. That would have been a disaster for Fnatic. That would have been a quad kill for Grubby if you could have picked that up. Now, Pete, you know, 1v2, but he's got some time. Does jump off the ledge. Not sure he made so much noise there. I don't think they heard that.
With no reaction out of Flusher, he's actually heading back into drop right now. So if Pete does decide to come through connector, I mean, there is the element of surprise here. He could catch them off guard. He has been spotted, though. Pronax should have seen him, and now, yeah, life gets difficult because up close, Flusher with that Swag 7. Perfectly lethal. Two shots, and it's actually Pronax who's going to rob him in the end. But well played there in the end by Fnatic, trying to just close off the angles, making sure that they weren't exposing their back so that Pete couldn't get an easy frag. It was very good to have Pronax sitting all the way back on the side, just spotting towards connector, not making it very easy there for the remaining Vex player.
Wondering if Pete saw Pronax in return as well, because if he did, then that hen house in the back there is just basically made of cardboard. You can shoot right through it and deal a lot of damage. So I'm wondering if he just didn't feel like going for it or if he didn't actually see him. Kind of made it like a movement, like he was aware that someone might have been there, but just a little bit too scared. I think 10-9, and moving into the 20th round, Fnatic just bringing themselves back in this game, you've got to say. And Flusher here could get shot in the back, but the team is actually just going to continue. They're not going to slow down, so Flusher gets the kill on the bomb carrier, and now they're all up in the bomb site with no bomb.
What is going on? Yeah, Vex, you just left your bomb carrier alone to peek an underpass. You can run up onto the site all you want, but if you don't have a bomb plant, I mean, you are not going to win this round. So Olfmeister gets caught, but still, four players alive here for Fnatic. A minute left on the clock here for Pete to make something happen. He's got that deagle. Seen how effective that's become after the last update. It just seems to see, you just see like deagle aces all over the place.
We'll see. Ooh, Crims with his knife out, but not going to matter. No armor there, so pretty easy kill. What really surprised me is that they didn't group up on Flusher.
Yeah, they didn't rush him.
Yeah, as soon as he misses the first kill there in underpass, that could have been really bad. That's going to equalize the score, make it 10-10. Going to move into the very last stages of this match.
And talking about pressure earlier, right, where we were wondering if Fnatic were the ones who were starting to crack a little bit, showing some tension, that kind of mistake could be, you know, Vexed also starting to feel the heat a little bit here. You know, Fnatic now have tied the score up 10-10. They're perfectly capable of taking the next rounds. Their money is starting to look pretty decent on Fnatic, especially after a good anti-eco like that. So, I mean, Vexed are starting to feel the heat, I think, Anders.
Oh, but look at this. JW's actually boosted up behind him. He's going to get the first kill, and now they have to move in on this bomb site. Otherwise, they're going to be sandwiched. Pronex playing close to the statue here, right in front of him. And Grubby is going to be going down. Root grenade for Erlen to follow up as well, and Pronex finally dies, but it's too late here. Rallon, the only one left, and now against four people trying to hide up on that plateau, but they are coming from every angle. They get the bomb plant. That's about the best we can say for this round here. That's going to be Fnatic taking the round lead for the first time since they won the pistol on the first half. 11-10, and I think you're absolutely right though, Vexed. The pressure has got to be on. They must realize themselves how much they got out of that first half, and to feel it sort of slipping away now, it's going to be really frustrating.
No, exactly, and that's where it really starts to ratchet up, and that's where the experience comes into play. When you've been in those situations where it's time to grind, where you're just going to be able to, you have to count on the tactics, you have to be able to count on everybody just playing at their utmost. Vex, they don't necessarily have that experience, whereas Fnatic, they have it in spades. I mean, we're talking about two-time major championship winners this year alone. They're looking for the Triple Crown, Fnatic. That would be incredible if they were to win this one, be the first team. Well, they're already the first team to win back-to-back majors, but to extend that lead to three?
Yeah, that would be quite a nice run. There's been a lot of skepticism recently about whether or not that's actually going to happen, because they don't look like they're in a sort of a godlike form. And I think this match has already been a decent indication of that, maybe. Pronex, though, with a good opening frag there. Grubby going to go down, and that is going to leave Vexed in a bit of an awkward position. If he got the kill, though, you can tell the rest of the team would have been ready on the other side of the map, maybe to catch some Fnatic members rotating back or just generally use that early frag as a way to get in on a bomb site. But instead, now they're just all stuck waiting.
And they're just hoping for somebody on Fnatic to make the mistake, but now that Fnatic have the man advantage, they don't need to be taking any risks. They don't need to push out. They can just sit and make Vex sweat, make them wait. 35 seconds left pretty much, and Olafmeister getting caught right on the edge of the smoke. There was a gap. I bet you Hyper spotted Olafmeister's boot. But that's going to open it up. Krims gets Molotov'd out of connector, and this is the time here. This is Vex's moment. Take advantage of that Molotov. Start pressing up onto the site. Flush is the only one here to stop this.
Well, speaking of time as well, they have to. There's only 20 seconds left, and Flush is doing a really good job. These counter grenades going to make Vex spend even more time. The bomb is dropped all the way in the far corner, and that's a disaster. Rallon a little bit off course there, and that's really going to lose them the round. Furlan is going to be going down as the last member. Good job from Flusher there. The grenades initially were good, but the fact that Rallon made his way essentially the wrong side of the squad truck there meant even if they got the kill on Flusher and somehow secured the bomb site, they would have to spend an extra 4 or 5 seconds that they really didn't have to pick up the bomb and go and plant it. So got to be careful about where that bomb carrier goes.
That's two bomb carrier mistakes we've seen so far from Vex, at least.
Yeah.
Whereas, like, the underpass one, and then this one right here, you know, you have to be... not only that, but I mean, did he even know he was carrying the bomb? That sometimes happens, where the bomb gets dropped randomly onto somebody, and they don't know if they have it or not, and then they get caught out in the middle of Africa. I mean, right now, it's going to come down to this rush again, and this time they're successful. Furlan will take out Flusha, but it is an eco round or kind of semi-quasi coming through here for Vex. They will be able to close in on Olafmeister, but still a 2-on-3 situation here. Fnatic fully equipped with the Kevlar, with the nades, and AWP on JW. This shouldn't have any trouble at all here, just locking down the remainder of this round. And Pronex with the blind spray through the smoke, taking out Hyper and looking for more.
Still a round where Vex do get a little bit out of it, considering the weapons they had early on. Two kills is not too bad. Keeping Fnatic a little bit honest, and we'll see if it's going to actually matter now that they can buy once again. 13-10 is going to be the scoreline. They could even go for the AWP and see if Furlan's going to want to pick it up here. And it looks like it's going to be a tactical timeout here for Vex. Now is not a bad time for it. I think they should be slowing things down right now and see if they could find a way to essentially get back in this game.
Probably thinking about that during that last round. It was pretty straightforward stuff. Kind of, it's been a long time since we've really seen teams take, like, Titan timeouts, right, where a very game's timeout, where they would just kind of sit and spawn on an eco and say, okay, we're going to run down the clock, use up pretty much a minute 30, and then just go run somewhere and die. But now you have that option to just back-to-back it. I like that they actually take the timeout before a big buy round like this, though.
Yeah. I mean, that it's one of the sort of points of criticism we often bring up amongst the top teams is that they seem to be bad at figuring out when to do these timeouts. Usually it ends up being so late that it kind of doesn't matter. So I feel like now is a good time for it. There's still a way back in the game here for Vex, definitely. But you can tell that Fnatic have found the traction they were lacking in the first half. Now they're feeling it. They're
that
ready
rhythm
for it.
They've definitely hit it. I mean, they're coming alive across the board. Pronex sitting with 18 frags right now above JW, and he's trailing right behind Krims with 19, Flusha with 21. I mean, Flusha's been leading the way for Fnatic right since the beginning of this map. It's good to see that he can just continue to maintain that major form that he's famous for. Wolfmeister still trailing though, so that's something, you know, it's obviously it's the first map of the major, and you know, we can't look too deeply into you know, individual performances just yet. But you are a little bit worried if you see Wolfmeister not leading the way. You want to see that man sitting at the top.
Yeah, absolutely. I do expect him to come alive later on, and like I said, I think Olof is already disappointed in his own performance. We saw him during that really, really nice interview that they did there before the match. He is one of those people who just like is like very self-motivated.
Yeah.
So I think he's gonna like pick that up on his own basically. But I don't think he needs anyone to tell him that that wasn't good enough.
Here we go. So this is the answer. Straight YOLO rush into Connector, not even going out the main entrance. They lead with the bomb, and it's a catastrophe. Flusha and Crims. They catch him in a crossfire, and Vex just ran right into the blender in a key round. They took the risk, they went for the aggro, and it was just right into, I mean, just all falling apart. What a catastrophe. This round is, that was never supposed to happen for Vex.
And what we see here, so what I tried to describe earlier as the cobblestone challenge, which is figuring out how to not lose B as soon as you lose drop mm-hmm. or plateau. Fnatic's response to this is simply to put two or three people in middle, and then two people on B, which essentially means sort of almost four people holding B. And then you have one guy who's maybe sort of just like peeking into A every once in a while, you know, seeing what's up. That's a setup they did in the pistol round as well, which is probably also one of the reasons why they won it. And they're very good at running it like that. This time it's only three people over at the B bomb site for Fnatic. But if time goes by, enough time goes by, see if they can make the switch and go back to a more secure setup here towards drop zone.
Whether Fnatic actually allow it. I thought that Fnatic were going to go for a boost there. JW's up on plateau instead, trying to find a gap in the smoke. He actually refreshes that smoke, but he does have it. He's intentionally put it a little bit onto the right. He's going to be able to spot it through, but Vex so far, they aren't falling for it. It looks like Pete, he's been boosted up on the box. He's got the AWP. He's just waiting for JW to misstep. But it's not going to happen, it seems. JW deciding to play it a bit more passive. Definitely a little bit more reasonable than we're used to seeing it. I mean, I would totally expect, you know, it's like JW, the only guy I would expect to see that is him, and he actually gets rewarded for playing the safe angle.
Yeah, Pete literally jumped right down in front of his crosshair there, so that's a bit unfortunate. He's down to 38 on the Swedish side, so now we'll see 38 seconds left here, and a nice headshot from Hyper. Flusher going to be coming in, followed up with a really good grenade there. It's the M4 kill, and that's going to be Hyper gone back to a 4 versus 3, and Flusher spraying him down. Furlan gone, and Rallen caught in a corner with very little HP. Not a lot of ways out in this round. It seems like Fnatic are really getting back into this game here. Right now, Vex have not won a single round in the second half. They are just being crushed, essentially. So that's match and map point for Fnatic, and I've got to say, I do feel a bit bad for Vex right now. I feel like they showed us so much in the first half, and they never got a chance in the second so far.
No, they've just been caught in this vice-like grip. I mean, Fnatic, if you were doubting them in the first half, and there was reason to, you were seeing some disjointed play from them, but not the confidence. But here on the CT side, after that pistol, they've just never given Vex a chance. You're right. And now, I mean, because Vex didn't get the bomb plant, they're limited on the money. They have no nades. They have a single flash, and they're down a man already. Pete gets caught out in the open at the top of Underpass. Furlan is there to get the refrag onto Wolfmeister, though, so they do manage to bring it back to a 4-on-4, but Fnatic, they still have all of the edge. They have all of the advantages in this round.
Trading kills here, and they're actually falling back. JW is going to be hunting them with that AWP. He gets a shot through the side of the wall, and Grubby's almost dead as well. Grenade not going to be working out too well, in fact. Exploding himself a little bit up. Not going to be too much. And we're back into a 3 versus 3 here, with a health advantage decidedly in favor of the Fnatic team. 3 kills, and they will have gone through with their first map.
This is nasty here by JW. He's actually going to use this smoke, and they're going to go through drop instead. Crims is hearing this as well. He hears the steps. He needs to react, and he picks off the man with the most HP. This should be easy now for Fnatic to close things out. And look at that JW. Only JW is going to run through and try and knife the guy. 30 seconds left, and the bomb is dropped in front of Connector, and now both players are ready and waiting there for Fnatic. Furlan with the AWP needs to make a godlike shot right now.
But the problem is Fnatic don't care. They can just wait for him to try and go and pick up that bomb, so Furlan doesn't have the time to play this game. He has to just go mad and run in here. As soon as he picks it up, they're going to be right behind him as well. 15 seconds left. He gets a shot through, and Crims right through the door, and it's going to be 10 seconds now. Furlan punching in those numbers and seeing if he can get the actual ace here to clutch it. That would be incredible in the first map. He's looking the right-hand side here. Pronax is behind that rock. The smoke is making him uncomfortable, but there's the kill. And Fnatic there will make it through. Furlan just one click away from doing it. Fnatic going to take it 16-10, which I feel like is a predictable scoreline. It just didn't happen the way that we were expecting. Look at that. All blue in the second half.
Yeah, the wall of blue in the second half here. I mean, that's just an incredible performance. Flush just nearly dropping the 30 bomb as well. He kept his shape throughout the entire first map.
Yeah. Well, quite a performance from Fnatic in the second half. Vexed, I think they did show us a lot, though, and I'm looking forward to seeing what the desk is going to be up to here. So Richard and the boys, take it away.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Anders. So, yeah, exactly like Anders said, it's a fair summary. Might have been a predictable scoreline, but it wasn't a